नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अनदर क्रिएटिव राइटिंग दैट इज प्रेसी राइटिंग। सो फॉर राइटिंग अ प्रेसी सम स्टेप्स आर नीडेड, बट बिफोर वी गो इनटू द स्टेप्स वी फर्स्ट लुक एट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ प्रेसी। व्हाट इज प्रेसी वी आर गोइंग टू नो। अ प्रेसी इज अ समरी एंड प्रेसी राइटिंग मीन्स समराइजिंग। प्रेसी राइटिंग इज एन एक्सरसाइज इन कंप्रेशन। A preci is the gist or main theme of a passage expressed in as few words as possible. It should be lucid or simple, succinct or brief and full, that is including all essential points, so that anyone reading it may be able to grasp the main points and general effect of the passage summarized. Then we will look at the procedure of preci writing. These are the steps that we should remember for writing a preci. First step is, first you read the passage through carefully. If one reading is not sufficient to give you a general idea clearly, read it over again and yet again. The more you read it, the more familiar will it become to you and the clearer will be its subject. Next, you are required to supply a title for your preci. This is a good stage at which to do this. Think of some word, phrase or short sentence that will sum up briefly the main subject of the passage. Next, select and note down the important points essential to the expression of the main theme. Here, you can do one thing. You take a pencil and mark those essential points in the main passage. Okay, then note the length of the number of words prescribed for the preci and write out a first draft. Okay, so do not write directly in your classwork copy. First you make a draft in your rough copy. The length should be 1/3 of the main passage. 1/3. Okay, if the total number of words in the main passage is 90, then you will make a draft of 30 words. You will make a preci of 30 words. That is 1/3 of the main passage. Okay. Next point is, in doing this, remember that you are to express the gist of the passage in your own words and not in quotation from the passage. Add nothing, make no comment, correct no facts. Just to make a gist or summary of the passage. Clear? Then you revise your draft. Compare it carefully with the original to see that you have included all the important points, and let the language be simple and direct that we have already discussed. Write down neatly. Now this is the last step. Write down neatly in indirect speech in the fair copy under the heading you have selected. So at last, you under the heading you will make a fair copy in your classwork copy. Clear? Okay. So these are the steps we should follow. We will have to follow for writing a preci. Clear? So these exercise for you students, you will have to make a preci from this given passage. Okay? In your classwork language classwork copy. So first you will copy this passage in your language copy, then you, according to the steps, you make a draft in your rough copy, then you will make it fair in your classwork copy again. Clear? So the passage I am reading it. One great defect of our civilization is that it does not know what to do with its knowledge. Science, as we have seen, has given us powers fit for the gods. Yet, we use them like small children. For example, we do not know how to manage our machines. machines were made to be man's servants. Yet he has grown so dependent on them that they are in a fair way to become his masters. Already, most men spend most of their lives looking after and waiting upon machines. And the machines are very stern masters. They must be fed with coal and given petrol to drink and oil to wash with, and must be kept at the right temperature. And if they do not get their meals when they expect them, they grow sulky and refuse to work, or burst with rage and blow up and spread ruin and destruction all round them. So we have to wait upon them very attentively and do all that we can to keep them in a good temper. Already we find it difficult either to work or play without the machines. And a time may come when they will rule us altogether, just as we rule the animals. So this is the main passage. You will have to make a precis on it. Clear? Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.